Hello again. A day and a half into the tournament, all the players, their families and supporters have demonstrated just how much this championship means to them.
We're
halfway through the first round. Already plenty of cheers, tears and beers have been served up. Tonight promises to be no different. The Dracula-loving darting showman that is Ted Hankey is about to make his entrance into the championship. After that, we'll see what Robert Wagner's got up his sleeve, or in his top hat, or in his ear. And we're hoping you'll help us resolve the debate on the best lakeside moment from down the years. And Bobby George is here. Enjoying yourself, Bob?
Lovely jubbly, Megan.
Now, John Kaczynski, the American number one, is going to play Ted Hankey tonight. How good a player is John? He's standing right behind you, so be careful what you say.
He's a very, very good player. He's been 3 years on the trot, number one American player. He represented America in the World Cup last year and won the World Cup, and he hit the winning double. He's been playing 10 years at top level in his country. Before he used to play wooden darts, the old-fashioned wooden darts, and then he went on to soft tip, and then he says he prefers the steel tip because it's more skill. And I was talking to him earlier, he said, I don't want a lot out of this game. I said, how's he going to play? He said, well, I want to hit a perfect nine darter, I want to finish 170, and I don't want to drop a leg.
Yeah,
he don't want a lot, does he?
Not expecting very much. No. Ted Hankey's got all the experience, he's been in the final twice. Well, how do you assess Ted as a player?
Ted, I always say, Ted is like a bat. He wants the A40 sometimes, he goes up the A1. He don't get there. But when he's on his route, he never catch him. He's such a powerful player. When he's hitting that groove in red bits, hitting his doubles, lovely player to watch. My favourite player to watch is Ted Hankey.
Coach Stompage joined us. All the best in the championship. You play tomorrow, don't you?
Yeah, I do. Yeah.
Now, what's it like playing Ted Hankey?
Playing Ted Hankey?
Yeah.
That's a different story. I mean, the man's putting up a show, he's doing all kinds of things. I rather wish he played his own game. It would be a lot better when he plays his own game.
Okay, now, what about John Kaczynski? Do you know much about him? Have you ever played him?
We played him last year with the World Cup, actually, with our team. We played the final against America, and they really beat us up 9-5. He's a good player. Got to be careful with him. No tricks, no jokes, because his men can play darts.
Now, can you explain what it's like to go out there and play on this lakeside stage? How do you stop nerves getting the better of you?
It's brilliant. It's absolutely brilliant. It's the best you can ever have in your life, I mean, to play up there. And I remember, like, 10 years ago, when I was just picking up darts, that was long ago, but anyway, I was lying on my belly watching the BBC, watching the lakeside thing, and I thought, like, if I can only play there once, it's a completely different experience. As soon as those doors open, first time you're bloody nervous, if I may say so, but after a couple of years, you get used to it, and what you try to do is to get yourself to the same level as the crowd is, playing responsibly with them, and then you're on the best, because otherwise you start thinking about the game, and as soon as you start thinking, you're done.
Co, thanks very much. Bobby, thank you very much. We're going to hear from John Kaczynski in a few moments' time, but before that, well, forget the Osbournes, what about the Hankeys?
Meet Ted Hankey, the man they call the Count, one of the most terrifying players ever to step up to the hockey. There is, however, a softer side to this Dracula of darts.
Magic moments when two hearts are dead. Magic moments.
It is just nice having him home, because he sometimes isn't away a lot. But yeah, it is nice. He's been home for a couple of weeks now and it's been great.
Lucky Mrs. Hankey has had her Ted home a fair bit recently. While the family were moving, they were filmed for a Dutch reality TV show.
As far as filming us moving, they just get in the way, really. Because you're trying to do things and they're there, they want you to do things, but you just want to get on with doing something else. It's just been a nightmare.
Yeah, but I'm getting paid for it. Well, they haven't given me any money yet, but I'll sort it out. You never know, this time next year I might get an Oscar for the performance.
Yeah.
Three.
Like many successful men, Ted does tend to take his work home with him and can spend many an hour practicing to the relaxing melodies of his favourite trance music. It will be his opponent, though, John Kaczynski, that the Count will be hoping to put into a trance as Ted attempts to regain the title he last won in 2000.
Now, I feel I'm ready for it. I'm not going to say I'm going to win it, because, you know, it's an old saying, don't say something you can't do. You look stupid. I'm good enough. I'm prepared, and hopefully it'll go well for me.
This was my dream to be a professional basketball player, which I wasn't tall enough, I wasn't big enough, and, you know, it just didn't work out for me. So I got into darts, and everything that I've ever tried to do in my life, I've always tried to be the best at. My dad kind of taught me that. So once I started playing darts and realized how good I was, now I just want to be the best there is, which I know is a goal that it could happen. Believe me, I have the talent to do it. It's just a matter of time now to see whether I can or not.
All right, Dad. Yeah, I appreciate it. Yeah, I'm sure it'll go well. I'll make you proud. Thanks. Bye.
I wish it was live at home. That'd be so great. But that's not possible for me. So I just hopefully get some tapes and take them home, and hopefully five of them. But we'll see what happens. I can't wait to get up there and perform. It's just that stage is, the whole atmosphere is just absolutely wonderful. And I'm really excited about getting up there and playing.
Let's get going. Time for an understated entrance into the Lakeside Arena as we hand over to Darts Master of Ceremonies, Mr. Martin Fitzmaurice.
Are you ready? Ladies and gentlemen, let's play darts! Midnight approaches. Darkness has descended. Will you please welcome the Count, Ted Hankey! From the United States of America, they call him Johnny K. John Kaczynski!
These two mean business, and in the commentary box, a world darts champion, John Part, a man who's been a central figure at every world darts championship in the 20 years it's been held here, and beyond that. Good evening, Tony Green.
Yeah, thank you, Ray. It's been a pleasure being here, I promise you. Another pleasurable evening, I would believe, because we've got the Count, and he can count. His opponent, well, John Kaczynski, a newcomer in Pennsylvania. Just these practice darts, just to get the feel of the hockey. And it's a strange place for the American, because we'll have never ever played under such crowds, cameras, heat. You'll have everything to contend with prior to throwing his first dart. Yes, get your teeth into it, baby.
First leg, have a good night. First leg. Johnny to throw first. Very best of order, please. Game on.
Well, off we go then, John.
Yeah, and it's John to throw first, and he's really been the top player on the U.S. circuit. from the last few years.
Well, a good start. No worry about the distance.
100!
There's 14 grand darts of Ted's. And Ted, who's moved his crit from North Wales to Telford. And he won the title in 2000, finished on 170 in the final leg. He won 6-0 against Ronnie Baxter. It lasted 27 minutes.
100!
Well, there's a host of them here this evening. A little bit early. A bit dark outside, John?
Very dark.
Yes. 100!
Best of five sets, best of five legs, that's the discipline.
And John Kaczynski, a very 99. Confident young man. I don't think he'll be very intimidated by this.
Johnny, you require 98.
Double 20, double 19, this is good. Single 3.
82.
Double 8 when he comes back, because he certainly will be. 182 on the board. He'll go all the way, the double one.
140! Johnny requires
double
16.
8 for John.
16.
And there it is. Used the marker well.
Leg. John Kaczynski! Second leg, Ted to throw first.
Well, he certainly settled in very quick.
140!
Just to remind you that the yellow dot is for the player that throws first. And also tell by the darts thrown. But better indication,
40.
The yellow spot. Two 140s from Ted. Quick throws, both of them.
180!
Well, that's the great leg to get down to 41 and 9 darts. And a good answer to Kaczynski's opening leg.
Well, I suppose you
60.
Could say fangs are what they used to be.
41.
Single 1, likes double top. Double 10.
Game on!
Well, these are the darts Ted has just thrown that won him the title in 2000.
60!
But a good first leg from Kaczynski.
Had Ted scoring it well, it seems now.
Well, I can't see him keep doing this up.
140!
He's already on a, for the first 9 darts, 122 average, 110 overall, and still popping him into the trebles.
100!
But not overawed. That's the good thing from this guy.
Yeah, he's extremely confident.
95!
Those slim darts, 14 grams of Ted Hanke.
42!
23 grams coming in. More dumpy.
41!
He just has to get his consistency a little better, John, if he's going to give Ted any trouble in the long term.
137!
Down to 82, a finish, no finish on 165.
Yeah, that's a break opportunity, so.
Ted, you require 82.
For early blood. The bull, 17.
tops.
42. Johnny Iroquois, 100.
Looked on by the pretty ladies in here. Ooh. 99, can't finish. Single 10, obvious, I would think. 58 scored. That's the one.
68.
Double 16 left.
Ted, you require 40.
Put the camera on Ted for double top. Getting closer.
20.
Wow.
Johnny, you require 32.
Surprising chance. It's double 16. Just waiting for Ted to retrieve his plate. It'd come off. It's double 8. Double 4.
28. Ted, you require 20.
Double 10.
Yes, that's 10 shot. And the third leg, Ted Hankey. Fourth leg, Ted to throw first. Game on.
Moving in for the first set.
60.
Ted, who's 36 years of age, has six children. Three girls, three boys. Still finds plenty of time to
125.
Practice.
76.
Probably stands right over to the left-hand side as we look at it. You're allowed to do that.
100.
You're allowed to do that as well.
Ted, you require 136.
Two treble 20s, double 8. Double 8. Oh, yes!
Game shot, and the first set, Ted Hankey!
His mother's in the air. There it goes.
First leg, Ted, yep. To throw first. Game on.
12 to her leg there. Hankey to wrap up the set.
Well, as I said earlier, John, 27 minutes for six 60. Sets in the final to win the title.
50.
Well, very close.
45.
Referee tonight, Rob Butler. For this particular match.
100.
Well, 45 to 22.
Well, yeah, he's only had 127 points and 9 darts, so a great chance for John to get a break early in this
80.
Set. Need more than 80, you believe. Because Ted at any time can come in with the 180.
Say that again, John.
140!
That was a prompt.
It's experience.
100.
Leaves him 94, no out shot. Kaczynski.
He could leave himself a double though.
120, single 19, it'll be double 16.
131. Ted, you require 94.
We'll go for the bull, I would think. Treble 18 could be a shot, but that's 50 of them. 44, single 4, double top. There it is, double top.
74. John, Johnny
break,
require
break
40.
Opportunity. Double top.
needs to compose himself. And that's
it. Yes, that's game shot. And the first leg, Johnny Kaczynski. Second leg, Johnny to throw first. Game on.
Well, he won the first leg of the first set, but then was lost the next three. Needs to keep the momentum here this time around if he wants to 95. Get back in the match.
Well, I like his style, John. I like his attitude. He's come straight in. Knows he has to really get into the groove straight away. Here's the averages. First nine, 99.6. That's the first 9 dots gone on each leg. Overall, 96. John, 79.4. It'll get better for John, I guarantee you.
97!
Well, in some of the legs Ted won there, John wasn't really in. You don't need to have the highest average, it's just the number of legs you win in sets.
59!
So, even though Ted's way ahead in the average, doesn't mean John's out of it by any shot.
100!
Not a few players from America from the same region. There's John, Jerry Unberger, Rick Nye. Reached the semi-finals one, yeah?
39.
Well, he's left 170.
60. Psyched up for it. See,
Johnny,
come on, Johnny.
170.
He really wants this.
Take it away, John.
Well, he's just low the first dart.
105. Ted, you recall, 157.
To rattle the chandeliers, needed trouble 20.
Well,
50. Johnny, you require 65.
Chance to go up 2-0 in the set. Needs double top now. Wow, one has ruined it.
He rushed it a bit, John.
He's eager. He's hungry.
45. Ted, you require 107.
60 to leave 47. He can still finish. Treble 18 ball. Still wants treble 18.
25. Johnny, you require 20.
So it's double 10.
Yes,
no mistake that time. Means a lot to him. He's up 2-0 in the set.
Kaczynski. Third leg, Ted to throw first. Game on!
So 2-0 down in the second set. What's Ted's answer?
140!
It's the first year in the championship, but is it his first year over to Great Britain, John?
He's played in the Masters on a few occasions. He's never really had any great success, but that's a lot different, I feel, than this. This is his first stage play he's had here.
46.
Well, give him his due. Doing a great job.
140!
Slim darts, Gordon Graham doing the job. 1-2-1 left after 9 darts.
135! Ted, you require 121.
Trouble 20 to leave 61. Trouble 17 to leave the ball. He can go for the ball, and he's going for it. It's like a 16.
Yeah. 87!
So 34 left. But 228 for John. He's going to have work just to get to an outshot now. Needs a treble. Yes, a good cover.
82. Ted, you require 34.
Who's there?
Yes, that's game shot on the third there. Ted Hankey.
Not the best double on the board.
Game on.
Now, a very important leg for John Kaczynski to hold his throw to take the set.
81.
Somewhat disturbing that. Standing back. What's the problem, Ted?
100.
Consistency win games. He's certainly a speed merchant, but they're all in the right direction.
140.
No lack of speed in this match. Fairly similar time to throw, I would imagine.
100.
Scoreline 2-1. Johnny Kay, as he likes to be known.
140.
Lead all then.
121.
Good third, puts him down with a realistic chance if he gets one. Because it's 20s for Ted. 61, 11, well, double 14. And a lethal finish. 12 dart leg.
Well, with Ted's wife, Sarah. Sarah, how nervous are you during that? First time I've been so nervous in a long time. Hello, why? Take it. What's Ted been like in the build-up to this? Nervous? Apprehensive?
He's been all right. He's been his usual self. He's always grumpy anyway, but there you go, that's Ted. But no, he's been all right. I think he's ready for it this time.
Well, we'll let you go. Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Was that crowded out by that noise? That 180, just as they're about to speak.
140!
180, 140s. Doesn't want Johnny Kay to take a set. So it'll be 2-0 in sets if Ted can. Well, he's still going so well. 101 left.
100.
Yeah, could be back-to-back 12 dart legs, or even better, maybe an 11 this time.
Yeah, 3-4-1, still. Still is battling away.
He will.
140.
I'll tell you, this because it's he never stops 81. Fighting.
We'll go for trouble 15. No, he's gone for 19. He told me if he prefers double 18 now.
41.
Knowing be coming back, the double top.
100. Ted, you require 40.
So it's double top for 2-0. Needs to bring it down. And that's right where he wanted it.
Shot. And the second set, Ted Hanke. Johnny to throw first.
Well, I think that Johnny.
Game on.
Plenty of time to settle in. Really? Just one or two loose starts has led him down.
121.
Yeah, we're getting the treble 20s and the odd one here, there, and everywhere.
He's done fairly well. I mean, he won a leg in the first set. He's won two in the second set. And to stay alive, he'll need to win three and take the set.
Well, I think he's done brilliant, John, for his first appearance, honestly. But Ted, in this form.
81.
We'll all be watching him now. He said he means business.
100.
There he goes.
That last guard right in the corner. It'll be difficult to see that.
Johnny Uriquois, 119.
19's with the first out. Trouble 20, double top now. Marley's options. Trouble 20 to lead double 10.
99.
And for a change, way behind. 180 though, leaves 97.
140. Johnny, you require 20.
Double 10. This one he's taken before.
Yes, that's game shot on the first leg. Johnny Kaczynski. Second leg, Ted to throw first.
Well, Ted's already thrown. We've had a bounce out.
80.
That's the speed of the man.
'95.
He's got them going as the former champion.
140.
And he's helping as well as Johnny Kay.
60.
Yes. Yes,
oh, yeah.
As well.
His second.
80. Two maximums in this leg from Kaczynski. Rattling Ted. Or is he?
83.
There we see four for Ted. 86. 180s, two for John. But it's the outshot that matters. Needs a treble 14 for double top or bull for double 16. Yes, it's double top.
Oh. 66.
Just on the knee.
Ted, you require 98.
Treble 20, double 19. Treble 18, double 12. No, it prefers a treble there following it on.
Oh, 80.
So for 2-0. Double
20.
10 for John. He's been successful with this one. Twice now, three times, he's confident. He's up 2-0 in the set.
Johnny to throw first. Game on.
Good action. Okay, back to Kaczynski.
78.
Good cover shot on the 19s. Going well, this lad.
60.
We see John Kaczynski's brought his average almost up to 90, 87.8 for three darts. Ted Henke, look at that, terrific average, 97. And that's what John finds himself against.
97.
But he's doing his best.
Yeah, we can roll back the years and Conrad Daniels, 1980. Beat Eric Bristow.
60.
And Eric's first ever attempt at the championship. So, we know what these Americans can do.
41. 180.
Well, he's having to hit 180s. Because he's being pushed all the way. Here's one coming back, surely.
123. Oh,
just in the treble one. And the hard part about that is left 162 as Johnny. No out shot. So Ted will have the first chance of the finish.
123.
And that finish should be 78. As his fans. Forty-two, single 10.
130. Ted, you require 78.
To save the set, John.
Yeah, 18s. 20 for double top.
Tops.
Yes.
Yes,
keeps it alive.
Third leg, Ted Henke. Fourth leg, Ted to throw first. Came on.
Well, in actual fact, this is the second time that Ted Henke's faced an American in the first round. In 1999, he beat Roger Carter 3-1 with an average of 100.74 for three darts.
Yes, and as I say, we've spoken about Roger Carter. Some player. But this kid is a good find.
100.
I watched his mother there when he took that leg, like a rocket from Cape Canaveral.
43.
Well, they're flying now. Oh, they do join in.
100.
All we need now, John, is meatball. Trouble 20, trouble 17, and the ball. Trouble 20 for double 12. There it is.
137.
And just looking to get a finish. John won't be able to now. Too late to switch. If he switches second, there might have a chance at it.
Danger required, 24.
It's double 12 for 2-2. Double 6.
12.
No worries, though. John's still at 219.
Yes, Ted's certainly back.
55.
It's double 6.
Ted, you require 12.
Marker is there. Yes. Yeah. Took him three darts. Well, off he goes. He has the advantage. He has to win this leg, otherwise it's exit.
44.
Ted, in actual fact, has enjoyed playing, John, because
140.
The speed side of it, both playing the same.
Well, I think that's a good point. They're both playing the pace they want to.
60.
There he is. Stance we're familiar with now. The perspiration there.
100.
He has a bit of the temperament of a John McEnroe, Kaczynski. Gets upset with himself if he doesn't perform. And he expects the most out of himself every time.
100. There's no one for tennis, John.
41. Ted, you require 161.
This is match point. Trouble 20. Trouble 17. Ball would do it. Trouble 17. Ball for the match. What a way to do it. Oh, so close. Tony David, Natalie, his girlfriend there.
And nothing for John to do, really, except get this 140.
100. Yeah.
He's going to come back, though, Kaczynski. He loses this match.
Oh, I feel so for sure, but it's double 8 for Ted.
Oh, now then.
Yeah, still no finish for John.
What a shame.
But you never know. If he could just get some pressure on, stranger things have happened.
60.
Still 136.
25.
Will he go the same way? Or will he go 1-12? No, it's 18.
He used 7 left. And he always used to go 1-12.
Yeah, he changed, John.
Now he's going for 9, and it's really gone all wrong. 7, so he needs 3 for double 2.
Yeah, single 3, double 2. He's got one dart for it. Double 2 for the match still.
21. Johnny,
well, this would be heroic for him. He needs 2 treble 20s for a double 8. Just cannot get it happening. But,
60.
There's some amount of pressure on Ted now.
Well, it's not the best double on the board, double 2.
It is now. Oh, they came back from 2-0 down in 2 sets to win.
I'll tell you what, give the Americans some applause there because he deserved it. But Ted Hanke in top form.
First match of the evening is settled. Workmanlike victory for Ted?
Yeah, very military. Proper darts, no missing. Done the job. Game over. All right, at the end, the last leg was a bit scrapped on the double, but there's no pressure on him, so he'd be well happy. I feel sorry for Johnny Kay, because he's going to do everything, and, you know, Ted started off so well, went out 136 in the first set, and it must have stunned the boy. He must have thought, oh, he's old with these guys. But he's done well. He'll be back in America. He'll have another go, I suppose.
Yeah, could you ever see John Kay winning that game, just the way it started out? Ted always looked in control, I felt.
Well, we've seen a couple of 2-0 downs and they come back, and I thought it was another one. But no, he's too strong for it. Ted was in command all the way. Steady darts, few turn-80s, good finishing, no pressure on him. He let him play darts, because when you've got the pressure on you, it's hard to play. But when you can bully someone, not in a nasty way, but in a darts manner, bully him, you can play your normal game. It's lovely.
With Ken, Bob, do you sometimes feel that he just seems to be absolutely flying? We're getting all the grimaces, he's enjoying it. And sometimes he just goes off the boil a little bit sometimes.
He goes to sleep sometimes, doesn't he? He does, he gets going and then he seems to, I don't know, takes his foot off the pedal, relaxes. He didn't today. He played his normal game like Ted Ken. Sometimes he does get a little bit wound up. If he misses a double, he starts planning at himself and, you know, talking to himself, but he played proper darts and tidy, professional.
You can understand that Johnny Kay is a little bit fed up about that, really.
Well, I would be at all. You know what I mean? He played well with the boy. He's had a go. He's got here, and he's got a taste of it, and he'll probably try next year to get back. Hope he does.
Bob, there's the count.
Well done,
mate. Cheers, mate.
Lovely job.
Congratulations, Ted. Workmanlike performance. Happy with the way you performed?
Yeah, I mean, I've changed my game around, like I was saying to a few people earlier on. I've gone from 9-8 there to win the first time I've ever done it, and at the 9-9 and bust it and all sorts. I play well, I'm happy, but I can play better, so we'll see what happens.
The experience of being at the Lakeside, you should have been here so many times down the years, I think this is your 8th visit. Do you ever get used to, we were talking before about getting used to performing in front of that crowd?
Not really, because when you walk out there on the first round, it's a nightmare. We ate it, all of us ate it. You know what I mean? It's always good to get through the first round. You can relax, you can start to prepare again. But the crowd's brilliant again out there tonight. It's superb.
A slight issue to take up with you. Sarah was saying you're a little bit grumpy in the build-up to these tournaments sometimes because it means so much to you.
Well, yeah, she just needs to leave me alone. Everybody needs to leave me alone and do my own thing, you know. It's just it's one of them things. Just leave me alone, I'll get on with it. I'll be all right after, like, now we'll have a drink.
Yeah. Happy with your game overall, Ted, the way it's been going over the last 12 months?
Yeah, I've had a good season again. Not brilliant, but a good season. I've lost in the final, I've won a couple of tournaments, so I'm looking forward to this. I'm confident, but you take one game at a time, like we always do.
Do you get an extra buzz from being here at the Lakeside?
Oh, it's incredible, yeah. Incredible. The atmosphere is just second to none. I just love walking out on that stage. It's what we play for all year, and I'm just happy to keep coming back.
Congratulations. Nice understated arrival into the arena this evening. Bats are flying about a bit, so you've got another big entrance in a couple of days.
Yes, I have. I'll see you soon.
Well done, Ted. Look after yourself.
Thanks a lot.
Now, just before we move on, there's something of a debate been running, and we hope you'll give us a little bit of help in resolving it. This is the 20th year that the Lakeside has played host to the World Championships. The last two decades have produced a myriad of magical moments, and this week we want you to vote for your favourite Lakeside memory. To help you, we've compiled a list of a top 10. All you have to do is watch, remember, and tell us your favourite. Details of how to vote will follow at the end, so just sit back and enjoy. Here we go. At the first Lakeside Championship, Eric Bristow faced Dave Whitcomb in the final. Bristow was going for his fifth world title, his third in succession.
Moving in, double eight, three darts to go. Double four. Double two. Yeah!
Crafty Cockney took the final 6-0. He was to make 4 more final appearances, but this was his last title. This was Jockey's second final. He'd beaten John Lowe to win in 1982. This time, the wee man from Kirkcaldy faced Eric Bristow, who was in his 8th final in 10 years. The ex-miner took the title 6-4, but was never again to feature in a final. Paul Lim faced Ireland Jack McKenna in the second round of the 1990 Championship. Lim is the only man to have represented 3 countries on the hockey: Singapore, Papua New Guinea, and the USA. Yes, he's there again! 141 points away from 52,000 points. Yes. Yes! Double 12! Paul Lim became only the second man to hit a Television 9 darter, the first and so far only at the Worlds. World champion in 1990, Phil Taylor was back in the final 2 years later against Mike Gregory. It went to 5 sets all, 5 legs all, sudden death. Closest to the ball to throw first.
Could not win the title. No, Gregory could have been champion, but is it going to go to Taylor?
Double top. But the cliffhanger went to Taylor. His average of 32.53 remains the highest for a lakeside final.
Gregory had the chance, but there you have it. Look at him out there. What a final, the finest final we've ever had.
With a severely injured back, Bobby George could hardly make it to the hockey for the semi-final against Magnus Karras. No one gave Bobby a chance as he trailed the Swede 4-2 in sets, 2-0 in legs. Bobby won 9 legs in a row to reach the final, where he played John Part. In considerable pain, Bobby was to lose 6-0. Barney faced Richie Burnett in the 1998 final, having lost to the Welshman in the final 3 years earlier. With the Orange Army raising the roof, the match went to an 11-set tiebreak.
Well, I think we've got to be fair. He deserves to go to a tiebreaker, and that's exactly what we're in now. Can he do it in one for the title? He's there! He's there! Look at him, Ray Barnable! He's crying!
Barnable!
That's what this title means for him.
Against Martin Adams in the 1999 quarterfinals, Chris Mason was 4 sets to 1 down and behind in the 6th. Incredibly, Mason came back to 4-all, forcing a last set tiebreak. throughout this championship, the count had been in imperious form. That continued against Ronnie Baxter in the final.
There's one. There's two at the bullseye for the title. Yes! What a shot to win a world championship!
Ted took only 46 minutes to win 6-0. Over the week, it set a record by hitting 48 maximums. Tony David, 50-1 outsider, shocked everyone by reaching the 2002 final. The Aussie, Hemophiliac, took a 5-1 lead over hot favourite Mervyn King.
Tony David!
Despite a keen comeback, David held his nerve to complete a tale of triumph over adversity. Andy Fordham looked like missing out on the final once again when he trailed Barney 3-0 and 4-2.
Well, it's 20s now. Treble 20 for double five. Well, ball. To save it, they hold it.
Oh, look at this. The fumble is
up ball.
But the four-time semi-finalist four right back.
Good marker, move across, good eye line.
He's got it! You
will not Barney remarked it was like a spaceship from Mars had landed and taken darts to another planet. And to vote, all you have to do is text the word darts, followed by your favourite moment, the number 83199. Text the charge at the standard rate, and lines will close at midnight, Friday the 7th of January. Each moment has a one-word title. For example, if Bristow's win in 86 is your favourite, text the word darts, followed by Bristow, to 83199. Alternatively, if you want to vote for Jockey Wilson's win, text darts, followed by Wilson, to the same number. And once again, here's the full list. Great memories. What do you reckon's winning so far at this voting started this afternoon?
If it was up to me, Raymond, Bob would go to 10 Yankees, 170 shutout. To go 60-60 ball, to win the match, and to be world champion. Can't beat that.
It's Paul Lim that's actually winning so far.
Well, he got he got 50 odd grand. That's pretty good.
Do you know where you are so far, mate?
Bottom.
Yeah. We nearly saw you bottom, but only 8% so far, but the voting continues.
Oh, well.
A couple of cracking matches this afternoon. Martin Adams found himself two sets down against Gateshead's Davey Richardson, but managed to fight back and win.
Double top it is.
Standing here applauding what is in my mind one of the greatest first round matches I have ever witnessed.
Martin Adams not the only relieved man tonight. Essex's Tony West was playing Rick Hofstra. He found himself two sets down, but he managed to stage a dramatic comeback.
It's double 16, one darts, yes! Yeah! Well, an amazing escape, but really Hofstra not taking it when he had his chances.
It's a Houdini act for the number four seed, but he's through. Three sets to two.
That's not me up there. That's not me up there. Everyone knows it. I know it. And it's not me up there. I'm struggling but to pull through. And it's just, I'm happy. It's lucky days. Happy days for me, I think.
Tony West very relieved too. Well, all the players, everyone hates to go out of the championship over the opening weekend. Norway's Robert Varga and Finland's Jarkko Kombula were both hoping it wouldn't happen to them. Now let's join this match with Jarkko 2-1 up, but Robert is 2-1 up in the fourth set. More commentary from Tony and John.
Only
57. He's through there with the advantage. Trying to save the set. 2-1 in legs.
59. 100.
All in line. 100, 123. Well, there's a barrel for you. Difference at the end, not bulbous.
60.
24 gram darts, whereas these, just 20. I think Ted Anke has the lightest darts, 14 grams.
85.
Brilliant.
140. Piotr Yurkwa, 136.
Two treble 20s, double 8. It's double 18 when he comes back to the hockey.
94. Yarko, you require 36.
To force the fifth leg, double 18.
Yes, that's game shot. And the fourth leg. Yarko
every leg Miller has gone with the fifth advantage leg, of throw.
Robert to throw first. Game on.
It's Robert to start this one, but a must-win leg for him to keep the match alive.
60.
And not a very good start.
Yeah, starts the leg, but has to finish it. Otherwise, Jarkko will be through for Finland.
100.
That's the advantage. 40. Rushing through.
36.
Chance of error in this leg. Jarkko could punish that.
21.
Gotta forget them two single ones. That's the good marker he's looking for.
60.
It's the first treble.
100.
Robert there, he wants to get on with it, doesn't he? Maybe not enjoying the pace here of Jarkko.
96.
You watch him straight up to the hockey before he's gone back, he's released.
Oh, I'm sure he's desperate to take the leg and stay alive.
59.
Only 146 left, so Jarkko can leave himself much better.
He's not into trouble in this leg.
Well, he had three single 20s would have left him an out. Now he has to get a treble because of that one.
40. Robert Yurkwa, 146. 98.
So 184, but facing another set, which will be the final set.
100, Robert E. McQuire, 48.
16, double 16 for the fight back from the magician. Yeah. Is there as well.
And the fourth set, Robert Wagner. Fifth set, first leg, Yarko to throw first. Game on.
Well, we said it'd go all the way. Nothing to choose between the two.
81.
Well, he's just somehow found a way to keep himself into this match, get us to the
94.
Fifth set.
Can we have the best of order, please, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you.
Been a long day. The thing is, Yarko certainly had everything going for him in the first couple of sets.
58.
But he stuck at his job, did the magician.
Norwastrian magic.
Time for him to put so much concentration into his game, isn't it? He's still managing.
180!
All the remainder meters up in the air all over the place. Might have to stay up.
180!
Yes! Brought him down quickly.
Down to two.
Is he going for ball? Yes, double 16, we're losing it. Double 16. Yes,
yes, that's game shot on the first leg. Yarko Kamada. Second leg, Robert to throw first.
Great excitement.
I think I missed something there.
It's all right, John, I was watching.
100.
It's the speed of it, that was the trouble. Yeah, falling short now.
43.
Almost know when you're going to get a bad score from Yarko. Fall short below that treble 20 bed. This is more direct, straight through.
100.
A little flick. As I said, look at that, straight as an arrow.
140!
Look at these, Yarko, more in dip, as the dip through the air.
60! Robert, you require 161.
And he's done it once, he won't be doing it this time.
65!
He has the highest out shot of the championship on 161, is Wagner.
Well, they really didn't need to take it out there, so far ahead.
80.
96.
Required, 96.
A good finish for two darts. Three now, treble 20 needed. Double 8.
Yes,
and we're back level again.
It's 2-2 in sets, it's 1-1 final sets. But now a chance for Roberts to step in.
Sixty. 28.
He's throwing a javelin now, John. Yeah. Really hurling him through the air.
He's hurled into the lead. Straight back, Yarko.
135.
See if Wagner breaks here, he'll be able to throw for the match in the next one.
57.
He's coming good at the right time.
100. Yarko doesn't like the idea of that.
Want to lose him 1-2-3? That's elementary.
He's doing everything he can to hold his throw. But still, pursuing is Wagner. Some trouble, yes, he's at 104, so real pressure on Kamila.
123.
19's the shot. Trouble 19 on the single. Wants trouble 18 now for the ball. Well, trouble 20. 104 left. Oh, geez, made a right mess of that.
Big shot for Robert before, and now he can try and take it out. Needs trouble 18. Yes, double 16 to break.
Yarko, you require 79.
Not a very good finish for three darts, actually, 99. We're checking the score.
24 score. Yarko, you require 99.
That is correct.
Well, he was quite honest to stand up and say, look, this is a three-dart outshot, not a two-dart one.
Yeah. Not a very good outshot either. There's the 19. Trouble 20. And only the single and living hope.
59. Robert, you require 32.
It's double 16.
Yes,
and he's ahead in the match.
Robert Wagner. Forward, Robert to throw first. Game on.
Well, Robert was down 2-0, and he finds himself with the throw for the match.
Well, you talk about magic.
100.
He hasn't got his cape on. He hasn't got his wand.
And at no
darts are doing the talking now.
And at no point were mirrors used in this comeback.
Straight down the hockey, straight into the 20s.
100!
40 ahead, plus these.
60!
He doesn't give in, I promise you.
No, he's working very hard. Still anyone's leg.
Fancy Wagner after that one.
78.
Wow. Didn't get leave a finish. 1-6-3. So, Yarko can take control. But hasn't.
58.
1-6-3. Can't finish on this throw. One of the bogey numbers.
59.
Might have been better staying on that treble 20. Had a good marker for it.
136.
Oh, excellent darts.
Robert Iroquois, 104.
He's already got the treble 18. He wants a single over 10. Well, he wants double 18. He went for 14. We can't see that, but it's obviously not there.
Yarko Iroquois, 50.
Yeah, to force a tie break. Needs double 16. Oh, it's obstructing the double a bit. He's had to move over to the left to try and come around, and he's successful.
Game shot. And the fourth play, Jaakko Kamila. With the score being 2 sets all, 2 legs all, we now go into the tie break. Fifth leg, Jaakko to throw first. Game on.
So, the game of 2 halves. First half to Kamila. Second half to Wagner. It's now a tie-break stage. Has to be won by 2 clear legs.
100!
Of 1 tons.
100.
4 on the trot.
59.
Well, if it comes to fitness in this match, this man has it in the gym every day, the weights. We've seen him somersault right across the stage previous years. I'm sure if he wins this, he'll be too tired to do that.
42. Robert Iroquois, 161.
Seen that on many occasions. Trouble 17. Trouble 20.
82.
A good start. Can only bring it down. Would like to be under 100 or on 100.
140.
Very good shot to pressurize.
Robert Iroquois, 79.
But it's the break opportunity of Wagner. He's 20 for double top. For 3-2.
59. Jaakko Iroquois, 60.
So there you've got to take them. Single 20, double top. Turn the tables. Double top. He's looking
Robert
into the sunset.
20.
Double 10. Bent the wire.
No score.
Doesn't believe it.
Well, he couldn't have asked for a better chance than that to break.
Require 40.
I think that this could energize Jaakko into hitting this double top.
Yes, that's game shot on the fifth leg. Jaakko Kamila.
What an advantage.
Robert to throw first. Game on.
Just to remind you, tie break, 2 clear legs. Jaakko can take this one. Then the match is over.
100.
Yeah, he's not got the fluency of the throw. Now he's flicking 1 or 2 darts. That's the tension coming through. so, 85. So important to these players, the World Championship. It should be down to a decent finish after these three.
65.
Here we go. 120, better than 117.
Oh, great first start. 17 now for double top to stay alive.
Yes, that's game shot on the sixth leg. Robert Wagner. Seventh leg, Rockers are throw first. Game on.
Well, how many more tricks has he got left in his hat? He's pulled out some big stoppers. It's all level. Once again, got to win by two clear legs. It's all
57.
Square. There it goes. It's just creeped into his game in the last
60.
Set or so. It's like the yips, John. On a couple of occasions I've noticed
60.
It. So he's normally so fluent, straight through. He managed it on those, but
94.
I noticed three or four throws.
100.
Well, Wagner's taken advantage away.
100.
Still, he got trouble 20 with it.
One for the start, so treble 19. Yes, he's on 24 left. And that's going to give him a break chance.
I think there's rabbits running all over the stage from the magician.
138. Robert Yurkoy, 24.
Double 12. Wow, it's 15 now, so 7 for double 4. Or 3 for double 6, maybe. And it's 15 left. 7, so double 4 to move ahead.
Yes, that same shot on the 7th leg, Robert Wagner. 8th leg, Robert to throw first. Game on.
There it is, in slow-mo. Got a lot of fans, as Robert. But here we go. Every chance now with the darts.
41.
The yellow dot in the right place as far as Wagner's concerned.
Yeah, well, it certainly wasn't the start he was looking for.
140.
This could go all the way, Tony.
To finish it with this leg, and that's the way to do it. That's one of Bobby's sayings.
60.
Yes, another one. 4 on the top. Straight, direct, looking fit.
100.
He won't shake this kid. No way.
59.
Take it off. Oh, only 24. Well, it leaves a finish of 1.56, but he should have been looking at a better shot than that.
There's still trouble needed for Carmula to get to a finish. There it is.
There's that 100. Flick.
Robert Urquhart, 156.
Two treble 20s. That's the ask. One. Another. Unlucky. They can stay there. Leave double eight if he can hit it.
140!
Could be his last of the match. He must get a treble. No, he won't be able to save it. 77 leaves 65, so 25 would leave double top.
134! Robert Urquhart, 60.
This is the one. Double eight, yes, it's there! It's all over! Well, roll over Beethoven. Wagner's in. But it was a long, stretched-out match. Some great darts along the way. But it's once again, it's Wagner into the second round.
We've retired to Bobby's private bar. Does Robert have the game to trouble the top players in the match, in the game?
Oh, yeah. He's been around a few years. He goes in all the opens. He's very dangerous. He wouldn't be here. He's earned his place to get here. He's a dangerous player. He enjoys his darts, he loves the fun bit, he's a very lively sort of guy. And the further the game went on, the stronger he got. He was quite deadly on his shots out, and he's scoring.
And I think the lesson to be learned that if he leaves 16 or 40, well then you're in a little bit of trouble, aren't you? Because if you look at the percentages how he did here, well he was 4 out of 4 on double 8.
Well, that's perfect, isn't it? 100%.
And 4 out of 6 on double 20, which is absolutely terrific.
Playing badly, but...
He's a hyperactive sort of player, but when he gets his game going, he's really good, isn't he?
Yeah, well, he proved he could not only hit the doubles, I mean, he got the scores to lead the doubles in him. And he kept pushing, he never gave up. In this game, you mustn't give up. He's two sets down, he thought, and everyone's thinking, oh, he's out. But not Robert, he thought, no, keep going. And the longer the game got, the more stronger he got. Mm. He got more confidence, he felt like he can do this. And he was behind all the time for the last two legs. I mean, all the way through. For the hour or so what he played, so he showed a lot of character there. He done very well.
Right, let's just check on the results so far today and see who's been winning and losing. Martin Adams had a real scare against Davey Richardson, but managed to come back and win by 3-2. Very relieved man, Martin Adams, as is Tony West, because against Rick Hofstra of Holland, well, Rick was going well, and he had a dart to win the game, but Tony came back to win that one by 3-2. As we've seen, Robert Wagner beat Jarkko Kamila by 3-2. And Robert will now think he's got a bit of chance of making progress. And it was a workmanlike performance for Ted Hanke. He's been to the final twice, 1-1, lost 1. American number one John Kaczynski really didn't give much of a fight to Ted this evening. That's just about it here on BBC Two. But as the great Roberto Giorgio will now explain, live darts continues over on BBCI.
All dart players love to hit the red bit. Cancel that. Love to hit button, the red button. And this year on the BBC at Lakeside World Championship, if you see the interactive button come on your screen, press the red button on your remote control and you will see live darts as it happens. As it happens, you're going to see some world-class darts. I'll tell you what, we'll give it a go.
Two of them. Yes, three.
Great stuff. Punters, go interactive. It's as easy as that.
Live darts, BBC, our highlights, quarter to 12. If you're out in the Frimley area tonight, be careful. Ted the Count Hanke is celebrating, and he really fancies a drink. Goodbye.